Are you looking for Cloud Architect interview tips? If so, this video is for you. The Cloud Architect interview is really the key to getting a great Cloud Architect job. And whether it's your first Cloud Architect job or your second Cloud Architect job, no matter what, you still need to convince the hiring manager that they need you on their team. And if you understand the hiring manager's job, you'll be in a great position to sell yourself to the hiring manager. I'm going to talk about the hiring manager's job. And if you know the hiring manager's job, I want you really well prepared for your next Cloud Architect interview. I want you to know, what does the hiring manager get paid to do? What does the hiring manager get promoted for? What are the things that will affect the hiring manager, which could get them terminated? And what are the things that get your hiring manager a bigger bonus? Because if you can get your hiring manager paid more or promoted, they're going to be very likely to hire you. For the most part, Cloud Architects or AWS Solution Architects or Azure Architects work in a pre-sales environment, which means the goal of these careers is to design, present, and sell technology solutions to the client to improve the client's business. And hiring managers are going to be judged by the effectiveness of their team. And for the most part, they're going to be judged on things like sales and customer satisfaction. But the manager will also be judged by things like reference accounts, Spiffs, the visibility of their team, and their team's effectiveness. And I want you to understand what each of those are so you know how to sell yourself to the hiring manager. Team sales. The hiring manager will carry a quota or an amount of product and services they're required to sell every quarter. The more the hiring manager's team sells, the more the hiring manager is paid. The less the hiring manager's team sells, the less the hiring manager is paid. And if the team does not sell enough, the manager will be terminated because they will be seen as ineffective. So on that Cloud Architect interview, you must show the hiring manager that you know how to sell, because it's critical for your success and the team's success. Customer satisfaction scores. Hiring managers are going to be judged based upon how happy the customers are. See, the hiring manager will send customer satisfaction surveys to the customers. And the higher the satisfaction scores are, the better the manager will be paid and potentially the team members. If the satisfaction scores are average, there'll be no additional bonus. But if the satisfaction scores are bad, the hiring manager and or members of the team may be terminated. So please show on your Cloud Architect interview that you can deliver excellent customer service. It's critical to getting that Cloud Architect job. So show it and make it clear to the hiring manager you can deliver exceptional customer service. If a hiring manager's team is able to collect a big account that's willing to issue a press release, for example, or write a white paper about why the solution improved their business performance, that's really effectively a customer testimonial. And these types of documents or reference accounts are highly strategic to an organization and can promote significant sales. And therefore, managers will be rewarded every time there's, say, a reference account or a big reference account or maybe a big press release that can affect the manager's pay. So in order to do so, please show the hiring manager that you're good at sales, you can understand your customer, and you can make your customers very happy over the long term, and you can build deep relationships, because that's really the key to getting reference accounts. Spiffs for strategic tech sales. Every company is going to have some new technology that they feel will give them a competitive advantage. And a company is going to want you as a Cloud Architect to design, present, and sell solutions around that specific technology. So if a company has a brand new artificial intelligence solution, for example, and they say anybody that sells this gets an extra bonus, which is called a spiff, they're going to be very happy if you can sell these new things. Now, what does it take to sell some brand new technology you've never worked with? The ability to learn quickly and the ability to communicate it effectively. So when your Cloud Architect interview, show the hiring manager that you're adaptable, flexible, and can learn quickly. It'll really help you on that interview, and it'll help you in your job as well. Team visibility. One of the things that's going to get really noticed by the manager and their management is that their team is being known for doing some great things. Maybe someone in the manager's team is speaking at a major industrial conference, for example. Or maybe somebody wrote a thought leadership document that's posted on the company's website. The more of these things the manager team does, the things that are seen by the company's leadership, the more the manager will be promoted and paid and bonused, and therefore the team may get promoted as well. So managers are going to be looking for people that really can promote team visibility, because after all, a manager wants to get promoted and they're going to want to promote their team or members of their team for doing a good job. Teamwork. A manager is going to be judged by the effective output of their team. And if the people of the team are happy and cohesive, chances are they're productive as well, and the manager will be rewarded. If the people on the team are in constant conflict or complaining, they won't be effective and the manager might be terminated. So the manager is going to be keen to look for people that can keep a team harmonious. Now, what are those skills that keep teams humming along where everybody's happy? They generally have good communication skills, the people have high levels of emotional intelligence, and good leadership skills. So hiring managers know this, and they want to make sure their team is doing a good job. So they're going to be looking for people with great communication skills, high levels of emotional intelligence, and good leadership skills. So make sure you show that to the hiring manager on your interview. In this Cloud Architect Interview Tips video, we covered things from the hiring manager perspective. I really want you to think about how hiring managers are paid, the things they get promoted for, and use that to sell yourself to get cloud hired in your next Cloud Architect interview. To learn how to become the ultimate cloud architect, or how to get your first cloud architect job, or how to get promoted in tech, attend one of the free webinars that we have. The link is in the description of this video. We also have a tremendous number of free resources to help you in your cloud career, and you may find many of them in the description of this video. Lastly, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. And if you hit the bell, you'll be informed of new videos to help you in your cloud architect career. I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.